Hey YouTube, what's up? Before I head out the door, I'm going to do one more quick video, which really isn't a quick video. This is an important video. This is a video that's life-changing. No, not really. This is my Project 10 Pan video, but it's a little different. It's not going to be 10 products. It's going to be like 100 products. So I'm going to go through category and just touch briefly. I'm not even going to go over each product because that would be ridiculous, but I'm going to just touch briefly on like... And this isn't even my whole stash. These are just products that I like using. I've seen like success using them, I want to say. And it's like disappointing to myself that I never use them. Sometimes I skip different like areas of makeup. Like I won't use eyebrows. I won't do my eyebrows, which is silly. Or I'll skip the primer. You know, like sometimes people do skip primer. You know, sometimes people won't highlight. But anyway, I think I have enough of each just to kind of get an idea. There may be a couple of stragglers in makeup bags, like my travel one might be in my purse that, I've been using up, so I'm pretty confident to say I'll get through those products. I'm not going to include that because I do my makeup either at my vanity if I have more time in the morning, and that's still a 5-minute face. If I'm really running behind, I will drive to work, and then if I get there, say, 3 to 5 minutes early where I don't have to walk in yet, I will do that quick face in the car, which is basically just like a Laura Geller powder that you just put all over the face. It's like a correcting bronzer and powder all-in-ones, foundation, I meant to say, all-in-ones. And then I'll just do mascara, curl my lashes and do mascara and walk into work. Like if I absolutely have to, that's like my last minute face. So I'm not even going to include that because that I've been using up pretty regularly since I started the earlier shift at work. These are products that are when I'm sitting at my vanity. I'm not even going to include palettes because everybody and their mother knows we have like 20 palettes we need to like touch on. And some girls have a lot more. I would say I have 20 makeup palettes that I need to, for eyeshadow, give love to, in addition to singles. I'm not even going to go there. I promise you I will never buy another eyeshadow again, unless that stuff is 5 years old, 10 years old, and moldy. This is just more like other products. So let's get into it. I'm pretty good with the face products. I have, I want to say 4 foundations that I've been rotating out, and I'm pretty confident that by Christmas or January, when I get those like Sephora gift cards for Christmas or money to shop with, I'm going to buy 1 foundation. I'm always going to have Bare Minerals Matte for the summer, but I'm going to try to stick with 1 foundation. I'm going to continue to get samples from Sephora here and there to find my ultimate, and then I'm going to stick with it. I think that's my goal. But as far as face products, I have this Wet n Wild powder, which I've been enjoying. It reminds me a lot of the Rimmel Stay Matte. I put a pretty decent dent in it since I've had it. I didn't buy the foundation. I skipped that one because I couldn't find my color. I don't even know if this is my color, but it's just basically a light powder. This is called Warm Light. And I got it at Rite Aid for $4.99. I think I even had a dollar coupon off this line of Wet n Wild. This photo focus line. And it's okay. You know, I've been using it. I have Laura Mercier setting powder and a few others, but I'm going to try to get through this because this you can travel with easier. And then I have my MAC Matte Fix powder. It's basically their face powder. It's like a foundation. And this is a light one too. This is NC25. I think that's what I am in foundation as well, the liquid. And I'm just going to try to go through these two and then eventually, like, find which one is my fave. I think I have another one. I think I have a Bare Minerals Pressed as well that I'm trying to get through. As far as highlighters, I have a whole bunch. I have some samples. I have, like, High Beam I just used in a Get Ready With Me. I have Watts Up. And I do like these two. I think I like Watts Up a little bit better. But I'm always afraid that stick is going to break. I have this Becca highlighter. It came with the smaller sized powdery highlighter, and this is in Moonstone? No, Opal. And I never give those two love. One is in my travel makeup bag, and I'm trying to use the liquid when I'm at the vanity. I also have, everyone raves about this, the Laura Geller Gilded Honey. I never use it. I don't care for the way it looks on me. I might try to sell this because I've used it literally once. Why waste it? I have two hard candies. I have Tiki and Heat Wave, and I enjoy these. I've given it, I think I've got my money's worth because it's inexpensive, but this I don't like at all. This is the Wet n Wild Illuminating Palette. I don't like the way, I don't like any of them. I think I like this one only, and everything else I don't like, but I might just use that and then throw it out. I mean, it was only $5, Wet n Wild. One that I have to say I really like is Physician's Formula, the one that looks like this. It looks like a Bobbi Brown Shimmer Brick kind of, except it's in cubes. And I do like this highlighter, and I have given it a decent amount of love, but not as much as I feel like I've got my money's worth considering Physician's Formula is super expensive at the drugstore. Continuing with highlights, I just got my hands on Precious Petals recently. I feel like I was told this is a dupe for Champagne Pop. I've been liking this. And the one that I bought that I don't really care for too much is Crown of My Canopy. And this is way too dark for me. It's more copper. I'm trying to use these up. So those are my highlights that I'm just trying to use up. I still have a few more, believe it or not, that I'm going to try to use up. But moving on to primer, I have the Bobbi Brown. I love it. I'm going to use that up. Makeup Forever, step one, I hate this. But I think it's too late to return it, just like my NARS foundation. This looks like it's used up, but it's not. I used it like twice. And just a pea amount. So this has like the life of the product left in it. It literally turns to white on my skin. It makes it look like there's cement stuck to my skin and it has the consistency of cement. Has this gone bad? Has anyone else experienced this? I understand it's supposed to be a mattifier, but why is it turning my face literally like white cement? Almost like a mask drawing. You can't have this. Like, it shows up under the foundation. It's insane. And it takes a while to come out. So you'll be pulling into work and being like, oh my gosh, I have a mask under my foundation on. Like, that's insanity. You can't have that. The Angel Veil, I feel like this is a dupe for, like, the Hourglass. And I like this. I might get this again. I don't know. So I'm using up those primers. This I might not be able to use up. I'm going to try it again. I don't know. As far as lipstick, I was saying that I'm using up my MAC, and I've been really good about using up my MAC, but after I give MAC a few months of love, I'm going to try to get through some of these Wet n Wild $2 lipsticks. Even if I use them like 3 or 4 times each, I'll feel like I got my money's worth before they go bad. I have every color that they make, and some of them I have backups of like 2 of the ones. I think one's like a Dupe for Velvet Teddy. I have a backup for that one. So I'm going to try to use those up. They're really good quality. I don't know if the matte texture is still in trend, but I personally like matte lipsticks, so I don't care. Moving on to blushes. I'm not going to do bronzer because I have, I want to say 6 bronzers that I have been pretty good about giving them love. I have NARS, 2 MAC, Bare Minerals, and another drugstore one, I think Physician's Formula, and maybe one other, and I have been rotating those out, so I'm not even going to go there with those, but I have some blushes that I never, ever use. I very rarely use blush. I tend to just do bronzer, and that's it, but Coralista, I spent a lot of money on this Benefit blush. We all know how much these cost. It still smells good. I've used it maybe once or twice. Maybe. I have a Bahama Mama one in my travel bag I'm trying to use up because that's the bomb, and I did spend a decent amount of money on that too. Here's a MAC blush. It's a mineralized. I don't care for mineralized blushes, I've noticed. I like the other formula. This is hand wash. This was like a limited edition. It's got a pink and like silver lining through it. It doesn't even really show up well, but I'm gonna try to give it a little bit of love. This is way old packaging, but I love the color Dirty Plum. You have to use it with a really light hand. This is one of my favorite blushes of all time. It's called See Me, Hear Me. It's like a pinkish rose blush. Doesn't look like that in the... It's beautiful. I'm going to try to give that some love. And if I had to get a drugstore dupe for that, it would be Pearlescent Pink from Wet n Wild. I'm going to try to give this a tiny bit of love. Warm Soul, I just used that. I'm trying to use this up. I've used this maybe 3 times, and it's a gorgeous blush. Melba, it's a classic. Why don't I use it? I don't know. And then the trusty old Coastal Scents. I don't even know what to say. I've used it once, maybe twice. The quality's eh. I want to use it a couple times because I probably spent $15 or $12 on this, and I just want to use it up a little bit. That's my Project 10 pan. So other than buying mascara, I am not buying anything. I mean, granted, I might go through my primers a little bit quicker, so I may purchase a primer when all three of these are gone, which will probably take a few months. I'm not buying any makeup. I'm just not. I'm going to try to use up my palettes. I have 4 or 5 that I've been rotating out. I have the 2 Nakeds. I have a Buxom. I have 2 Too Faced. And I have one of those Coastal Scents, like the Natural. I'm going to try to use that up a little bit. I have some singles from Ulta. I have a couple of Chanels that I used for my wedding I want to give a little bit of love to. And probably a few more that I'm not mentioning. Maybe some, I don't know, Wet n Wild and some others. I'm going to try to give my eyeshadows some love. It's a lot of makeup. I don't even have a quarter of what these other girls on YouTube have. They must feel overwhelmed. I feel overwhelmed owning this much makeup. I really, at first, was leaning towards hoarder because I was so excited about makeup. And now that I've kind of come into my own and realized what works, what doesn't, what colors I'll never use, it almost seems like a sin to like keep it all. So would anybody use used makeup that I may have swatched once or twice? Let me know down below. I would be happy to get a giveaway going on of makeup. You can sanitize it. I will not be offended. I hate to waste like this. I hate to waste this. Maybe it'll use differently on your skin. I don't know. I have a lot of things that I would like people to enjoy, and let me know, including body sprays and other things. I can make up a bin and just, you know, send it out to someone because I hate to waste. So if there's anything you've been dying for and you're like, I love that product, why aren't you using that? I would be happy with that. I'll send it to your house. Let me know. Anyway, so I hope you like this Project 10 Pan video. This is New York Beauty XOXO. Peace out, people.